It was to be a brand new day in the American musical theater experience. However, the preview critics in 1943 didn't quite know that yet. See, Rodgers and Hammerstein had never worked together before, and the critics thought it was way too squeaky clean. There weren't enough jokes, and worst of all, the dancing girls were way too slow to appear. But there was to be more to this story.
After 5 years on Broadway, more than 2,000 sold-out performances, and the launching of a national Broadway touring company, Oklahoma had silenced all adverse criticism forever. And what a beautiful new morning it had turned out to be.
There's a bright golden haze on the meadow.
There's a bright golden haze on the meadow.
The corn is as high as an elephant's eye, and it looks like it's climbing clear out to the sky. Oh, what a beautiful morning!
Oh, what a beautiful day!
I've got a beautiful feeling, everything's going my way. Oh, what a beautiful day!
On the surface, there's nothing complicated about the show. It's about real people, down-home types, about taking your best girl out to an old-fashioned social.
When I take you out tonight with me, darling, here's the way it's gonna be. You will sit behind a team of snow white horses in the slickest ring you'll ever see. Chicks and ducks and geese that scurry when I take you out in the Surrey. When I take you out in the Surrey with the fringe on top. Watch the fringe and see how it flutters when I drive them past at the strutters. You'll see folks will think that it's up and their eyes will pop. The wheels are yellow, the upholstery brown, but as for genuine leather, that glass could you roll right down. Taste of the change in the weather. Two bright side lights winking and blinking, rainbow fire rig, am I thinking? You can keep your rig if you're thinking that I care.
With this show. It was set at the turn of the century, a time that must have seemed like such an age of innocence, a time that in the midst of World War II really wasn't so very long ago.
The two main characters in the show, Curly and Lori, well, they're absolutely smitten with one another, though they're both too prideful and proud to admit it. Curly's trying to make Lori jealous, so he's invited another girl to the town social, but Lori's having none of it. She pretends like it doesn't bother her at all, and reminds us that there are plenty of fish in the sea.